You can click here to switch between technical and realistic views. In technical view, objects are displayed as a wireframe. It is advised to use this view for drawing, positioning, and rotating objects. In realistic view, objects are fully rendered. It can be used to have a better overview of the scene. It may also be useful when moving objects, as it will show objects' interpenetrations in real time. You can switch between orthogonal and perspective projections. Orthogonal view is advised when building the scene. Perspective view is advised for a more realistic rendering. You can use it in the report view for a fancier look. Enable anti-aliasing in order to smooth pixels' edges. Enabling it can reduce performance, as it implies more graphics computation, but it will improve the rendering quality. Here you can enable real-time shadows to always visualize shadows on objects. This will only be effective in realistic view mode. This is the shadow projected by the tree on the house. Now let's move the tree a bit closer to see when it will start shading the field. There is no default ground in PVSys scenes, so the objects don't project shadows here. To visualize them, you can create a plane underneath your objects. You can enable camera animation when transitioning to another view. Let's see what happens when we switch views. Now, let's see what happens when animation is disabled. Camera animation is purely aesthetic and it is enabled by default. You can show or hide back faces. Hiding them can speed up rendering, but it may also hide some objects' faces, like these ones on the silo. As the silo has no top face, faces at the back are not rendered, because they are oriented backwards. Use this only if you have significant performance issues. You can also show or hide cardinal directions, grids, and axes. Render preferences are saved when you close the window and restored when you reopen it. It doesn't concern the technical, realistic view nor the projection.